Hi, my name is Mary Latrice. I am founder of JTT Accessories and HiiiDeas PODCAST. I am here kicking it with Mike from Drill TV. Thank you so much. I had such a good conversation with you. Thank you.
Welcome to My First Time, the show about your first time getting high on marijuana. I'm your host, Mike Freeman with Dro TV. Today, I'd like to welcome our guest, Mary. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Very well. Thanks for coming on Dro TV and recording an episode with us. You can find more of Mary on Instagram at JTT Accessories at the Chillstone. And HiiiDeas While High podcast as well. We'll have all the links in the description below. So Mary, again, thanks for coming on Dro TV. Let everybody know where you're located and what you do for the cannabis community.
Hi, everyone. My name is Mary. I sometimes go by Mary Latrice. I originally born and raised in Massachusetts, but I've lived in Atlanta, Georgia for the past 10 or so years. What I am bringing to the cannabis community is conscious consumption. We have a cannabis accessory called the Chillstone, where we promote spreading or passing joints and not germs. And it's just a healthier way to not only consume flower if you do like to consume, but also so you're not sharing germs as well. So it acts as like a protective barrier that you can just put your joint in. And so when someone wants to share, I go to a lot of festivals where there's a lot of sharing involved. You can take your joint out and pass it and not have that contact directly on your mouth. So that's what we're spreading in the cannabis community, is just that conscious consumption, especially nowadays.
Yeah, very cool. I love it. Awesome. Well, I definitely want to get more into the Chillstone and everything else you have going on. But the show is my first time. So please tell us about the first time you got high.
My gosh, my first time was in summer camp. It was called Camp Mishnoa. I believe I wasn't a camper. I was working there. And we didn't have papers. There was like, we picked roses off a bush somewhere. And luckily somebody knew how to roll, because I definitely don't know how to roll. I honestly don't even remember what we smoked. It was probably dirt, now that I think back to it, but they rolled it up somehow. We took a couple puffs. I remember like coughing up a lung, and I'm just like, what is the allure of this? Because I'm not feeling it. So that was my first time. That would have to be when I was about 15.
Okay.
Yeah.
And this was in Massachusetts?
Yeah, this is up here, up north.
Okay. I'm in Orlando now, but I'm from Massachusetts. Where in Massachusetts are you from?
I was born and raised in Springfield.
Oh, okay. I'm a Worcester kid, so.
Okay, okay.
You're out in the field.
You went to the Hall of Fame?
I've been there many times. I got a good friend that lives in Chicopee, so.
Okay, yeah. I got a lot of family up there between there and Connecticut.
Very cool. Awesome. So, was it something after the first, so you didn't really enjoy it the first time? When did you come to when was your come to Mary Jane moment, I guess?
Honestly, probably not until I moved back to Georgia. And then the person I was with at the time was heavy in the industry. So they kind of schooled me, educated me on what is good weed versus not so good weed, what to look for, what not to look for. I mean, excuse me, what to look for and what to watch out for,
right,
when you're consuming. So then I started consuming more regularly, about 2011, I would say.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And so what spawned the Chillstone? Because it certainly makes sense. And I love products and entrepreneurs that, you know, solve problems and bring things to the table that make life easier and more convenient. So, and this is one of those things.
So for me, I like to go to a lot of music festivals, and I'm a bit of a germaphobe, but you know, when you're at these community events, there's just a lot of sharing. You know, you have a joint, people are just passing it around. And so I thought about like, well, what do you do when you, what's the purpose of a hookah tip? Mm. And I was at a event at Red Rocks, and I had this joint, it was a pre-roll that had this little plastic looking hookah tip on it. And I was like, you know, I'd never seen this before, but I found myself reusing it, you know, even though it was supposed to be thrown away. So I was like, I would love something like this that I could use full time, that was maybe a little bit nicer, a little bit more durable and reusable. So I was like, you know, we have hookah tips for when we're at the club and you don't want to share, it's supposed to prevent you and have that barrier. So why don't we have that for joints? I know way back when we had, you know, during the roaring 70s or whatever, they had like the flappers and people would have cigarette holders. Mm. So I was like, what do we call it when we have like joints? Like, is there anything specifically for joints? And I couldn't find anything. I found what people used to refer to as a smoke stone. Okay. Which is literally a stone that had a hole in it that people would use. And then just through accident, ended up being a chillum as well, because you can use it as a one hitter. So that's where the term chill stone came from. So after just brainstorming and doing a bunch of prototype and working with glass blowers, you know, we finally landed on a product to help prevent the spread of germs and just have a smoother smoking experience.
Awesome. Well, I love the product. What do they typically retail for? Something like what you're holding there?
Well, it's funny because this is a special one that probably won't even make it onto the website, just because I was just playing around with some designs, but it's so fragile because these are hand blown that this one will probably break very easily. But okay. The other ones that we have typically range from anywhere from 40, the really fancy ones, all the way up to 65. And then I do some hand jeweled ones that run about 75.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very nice. Yeah, I'm gonna pick one out because there's not a ton of festivals here yet. There's some. Uh-huh. I'm certainly health conscious and aware of mm-hmm. fingers touching things and going in and out of mouths. So
have any female friends that consume?
Yeah, I do.
Okay. Because I find my niche market does tend to cater towards women, because you know, we worry about our nails and our lips, and you know, guys are more, you know, a little bit more kind of
we don't care.
What's the word called?
Passive.
Yeah. So like that. So
grimy.
It's definitely nice for a female friend. Huh?
Grimy? Is that the word?
Yeah, not grimy, but they are more what's the word I want to use? I can't think of it right now, but they don't care as much about their lips and their fingernails and stuff like that. So right now, like when I'm at home, I don't usually use it until it's getting really low. And you know how the lower you get towards the filter, your lips, you know, you start to feel that heat. So this, you know, you can still weed out a lot of the, the ash that might come through when you're warm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the hot heat. That's actually when I first, you know, when we first started communicating and I was checking out the page and everything, that was actually one of the things I was thinking of using it for, because I smoke a lot of joints. And
do you use the filter?
I do, but when they get down low, I usually just put it out, and then sometimes I'll save them and roll up a, you know, second generation nasty ash kind of joint for whatever reason.
Yeah.
But yeah, maybe this will make them last longer and get them right down to the edge. So. Cool. Very cool. So you also have a podcast. Awesome. HiiiDeas.
HiiiDeas. Yeah.
Yeah. So talk to us a little bit more about that.
So I guess you could say JTT was a HiiiDea. It was birthed out of being high at a concert one day. when I had my kind of like aha moment. And I was interested in hearing other people's aha moments, whether they were high off cannabis or spiritually high and came up with a dope idea, started their business. I wanted to hear, you know, that moment and share that with everybody else through the HiiiiDeas platform. So
very cool.
That's where that came from.
Cool. This whole, my first time is kind of a high idea, but it's based off someone else's. But what's funny is my, this is a good one. My girl doesn't really smoke. And sometimes she has wild ideas like we all do. And she's like, is that like a high thing? Is that a high thought? So one time she actually did a dab with my buddy and I, someone that never smokes. Okay. And she was like, you know, I love the feel of football. Somebody should make a football couch, like a whole couch out of a football. And, you know, it was just one of those things. We were like super stoned. It was hilarious. It sounded ridiculous, but I'm sure someone's done it.
I haven't seen it. I mean, I'm sure it was just funny, but if, you know, some people get fixated on this idea and you go look it up, if you have never seen it before, then you start taking those baby steps to, you know, bring it to fruition. Because I mean, if you can think about it, it's probably possible. So now when 100%. You say a couch, you mean like made out of that material?
Yeah, the pigskin on the football.
The pigskin material. Yeah. That sounds like a great idea to me. I don't know how comfortable it would be, but I think it would be dope. Even start off with something small, like a baby seat. Footstool, recliner.
Yeah. So how long has Chillstone and JTT been around?
I first got the idea in 2017. I would say after like an LLC and finally getting like a product, maybe like the end of 2018.
Okay.
So 2 years.
Awesome. And so JTT Accessories, the line has expanded into other things?
So let's see. We've always had our hemp wick lighters.
Okay.
Again, promoting conscious consumption. A lot of people who use bongs or just tend to inhale when they light up should use hemp wick. That way they're not breathing in the butane. Mm. Also working on some smell-proof cases that you can fit both the Chillstone and the in your joints in, you know, like, you know, 3 or 4 joints to something nice and compact.
Awesome.
So yeah. Mm-hmm. I just like coming up with different designs. That's usually like my passion is working with different individuals to come up with different styles for different collections.
You work closely with some of the glass blowers? Like, are they local?
The glass blowers that I work with right now are local. It's a husband and wife here in Roswell, Georgia. A company called Flame Tree. Yeah, they're awesome.
Cool. Shout outs to Flame Tree. Nice. Awesome. Well, anything on the horizon? Any products you're working on or anything else? I mean, podcast. Any other venture you're working on?
Absolutely. So I'm definitely working on another collection that'll probably drop around October. And on June 22nd at 8 p.m., I am partnering with a few individuals to put on a virtual letter writing campaign. We're going to get together for about a half hour or so and virtually write letters to inmates that have been locked up for nonviolent marijuana offenses. And so I've done it on my own, just handwriting letters. But now that they have it virtually, I think we could do it on a larger scale and make sure that, you know, people know or individuals know that they haven't been forgotten, you know, even though they're unjustly locked up. So that's awesome. Coming up. I'm excited about that.
Excellent. That's an amazing thing. I try to talk a lot about jury nullification.
What's that?
A lot of people don't know this because they don't want you to know this, but every juror has a right to say not guilty. I don't think this person should go to jail for like you said, a nonviolent crime, something where there's no victim. Okay. So pretty much most drug crimes laws, possession, distribution, if there's no victim, there should be no crime. So what jury nullification is, if you are on a jury in the case that you're hearing, even if it's a traffic violation, something where there's no victim, okay, you have the right as a juror to say, I don't think this person should go to jail. And the more that people, especially jury duty and stuff like that, the more that people understand this is one of the things we can do, because our judicial system is so screwed up. If we're called upon to be on a jury, we can say, I don't think this person should go to jail, should lose their job, lose their family, their kids, whatever it is. You know, we can talk recidivism rates and everything else. So it's really the just starting through the system. The more that we take this ability and prevent people from going to jail, the less they'll want to prosecute these crimes, the less they'll want to charge people for, because sometimes they're charged with things that didn't even happen. Pile it on so that they plea out, right? So jury nullification is just one of those things that in the last couple of years I've read more about. Going back to the 1800s, people were talking about this. So it's, you know, like what you're doing is a great thing. But let's also remember that people are in jail for nonviolent crimes. And if there's something we can do to prevent those people from going to jail, then
ahead of time,
but I don't know exactly how this works, because people have been arrested or shunned for this, but I can't stand out in front of a courthouse and hand out a flyer talking about jury nullification. They'll say it's tampering with juries. So it's something that needs to be discussed outside of the courtroom, because, you know, a lot of the judges and prosecution and police, like, certainly there's good people. I'm not trying to say they're not all, but some of them are just trying to work their way up the ladder. Some of them are just trying to, you know, keep their case level percent win, you know? So it's a messed up system. And this is something where we as the people have the ability to, again, even if it's a traffic violation, something where there's no victim. Hey, everybody, I want to quickly mention Food Forest Abundance. Food Forest Abundance is a great way to create your own self-sustaining food forest and naturally occurring ecosystem that's commonly found in nature, but designed specifically for you. Through multiple layers of trees, shrubs, herbs, vines, rhizomes, mushrooms, and perennial vegetables, you can become your own supply chain without the typical maintenance required of a garden. From small spaces to large areas, both urban and suburban, Food Forest Abundance wants us to get back to our roots in nature by engaging with our food production in a meaningful way. For more information, click on the link in the description below and start your journey today. Okay, let's get back to today's episode. So yeah, jury nullification is something that I especially in this industry that we're in, we know how harmless this drug is, this plant that people use as medicine, and they're going to jail for, you know, felony charges for possession of, you know, a couple joints or something ridiculous, their lives ruined. If people knew that if they were on a jury, they could just say, no, not guilty, hung jury, or most likely they wouldn't try that person again. And the more those things happen, the idea behind it is they will not want to prosecute or charge people for those crimes. So
absolutely.
But what you're doing is amazing. That's awesome. Because you're right. They do often feel forgotten because out of sight, out of mind. And
And the fact that people are making billions off of something that, you know, they were just trying to feed their family with, or, you know, whatever, it's legal now.
Yeah.
Make it right.
Yep. Mary, awesome speaking with you. Love everything you're doing. It's amazing. Let everybody know where they can find more of you.
So you can find me at JTT Accessories on Instagram, as well as JTTIP.com. That's my website. HiiiDeas is HiiiDeas while high. That's on IG, as well as HiiiDeas.com.
Awesome. Excellent. We'll make sure all the links will be in the description below. So make sure you go down there, give her a follow, check out the Chillstone if you're interested. It's definitely a cool product. So thanks for coming out with something amazing and keeping us clean and healthy.
Awesome. Thank you.
You're welcome. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you go down, smash that like button for Mary, leave a comment for her, let her know what you think of the Chillstone. And obviously, if you are watching this on YouTube, you need to go down and subscribe and make sure you don't miss any more make great guests like Mary here. So thank you again, Mary. I hope you enjoy the rest of your evening, and smoke them if you got them.